I still say clit.
You do?
I still say clit. You know, say we're like talking or something and we go home and she's like, I want to get fucked by your dick. I'm going to assume you want me to use like a strap-on.
What's your name and how do you identify?
My name is Leo and I identify as a trans male.
So how far are you along in your transition?
February 9th will be 2 years on HRT.
What defines being a man for you?
That's where it's going to get controversial a little bit. Everybody's different when it comes to what their guidelines are for being a man. I know cis men that don't even have guidelines as tough as some trans men give to themselves. When I meet a guy and I shake his hand, there's not even a think twice. So I am accepted as a male. And to me, that like was a big key factor. It's not necessarily a bottom surgery thing. Top surgery, absolutely. A male. The boobs, flat boobs, whatever it is, it just reminds me of being a female. But when it comes to the bottom, you get growth, you get clitoral growth. So when I see myself in the mirror, I don't see the vagina I had when I was a female or a lesbian.
So the reason this video might be controversial to a lot of trans people and just the LGBT community in general is because you are a trans guy that doesn't want bottom surgery.
Yes. Now, I've gotten actually shamed for that.
Yeah, it's not that you're comfortable. It's not that you were comfortable with having a vagina. It's that you're comfortable with what it looks like now.
You know, I went along and it really from the start wasn't a thing of that I wanted bottom surgery. As the clit grew, I saw it in the mirror. You know, the breasts were shrinking and all that. So I was like, well, this is the only thing that I don't want to see. But down here, I'm actually happy with seeing a large clit hanging down. You know, some people call it like, this is my dick, my baby dick. And like, I'm comfortable with that. Everybody has a preference of what they want. And for me, it was, you know, it's the top surgery and I wanted to at least sound and perceive myself in the public as, like I said, how I felt. It really isn't an issue of the bottom for me. I'm comfortable with it. And I think, you know, maybe with my sexual orientation, with me being open, it's never been a thing where somebody has told me like, oh, I don't like what you have down there. It's just never been a problem. It made me very comfortable with what I have.
You date men and women, right?
Yes. I was like, okay, well, I still like penetration and dick does turn me on, but I still like the femininity of a woman. So it just got to the point where, you know, it was okay. I might be just liking who I like.
If you had a choice to get bottom surgery tomorrow and it looked identical and functioned similarly, like it functioned identical to a cis male penis, would you want it?
I'd have to think about it. Now, when it comes to that, you mean like sensitivity wise,
is
everything, it would be as if you were born with a cis penis?
Yes.
I'd really have to think about it. The opportunity is great, but like I said, I like having what I have for certain reasons sexually. I like penetration. You know, I don't have a prostate, so it wouldn't be the exact same, even having a penis. I like the penetration. And I like that a female or a male can go down on me and it's not some big dick hanging there in their mouth and it's like, ah, like, and you're like, oh my God.
Are you big enough down there that you're able to penetrate a woman?
If I get hard, it can definitely like scale inward. I feel like because it's not even 2 years yet on HRT and I'm still growing and having all that. At the rate it's growing now, I feel over time it will get to a decent penetration.
What kind of backlash do you get from other trans men when you say this? I mean, there are some trans guys out there like Buck Angel who talk about how much, you know.
Yeah.
Not that he loves his vagina, but he works with what he has.
He's proud of what he has.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, how I feel as well. When I actually first started transitioning, actually his videos made me feel like it was okay to feel the way I felt. I was having people saying, well, how are you gonna be a man if you don't have a dick? And that was one of the most common things, like no dick, no guy. Like that's just how it is. But when you see somebody, especially somebody who's older and has been doing this forever, and they're comfortable with who they are and, you know, they do work with it and everything, you really admire that. And you really get to the point of thinking like, you know, I'm gonna just keep getting older and I really have to do what I feel comfortable for me. Or there's no way you're trans if you don't feel like you want a dick or you have to come in somebody. I don't believe that at all. I don't want the, I'm about to do surgery within a couple months, all that. That's my like dysphoric thing is I don't want to see this. And the voice and my facial hair, that was what I was worried about. And you know, it's to the point where I was like, okay, it's not the genitalia.
I think a big misconception with trans people is that you have to be completely trans. Like there's a way to be
like there's a poster on your wall with a chart that you like, literally have to follow.
You have to have facial and hair and
no ass play or no dicks allowed.
Most of the trans people that I hang out with and I get along with on the internet now, like Ryan and Calvin, yeah, they believe that, you know, you have to have some type of physical gender dysphoria to be transgender, whether that's voice, facial hair, or lack of facial hair.
Exactly, and that dysphoria is what's gonna lead you to doing your transition. You know what I mean?
Do you think that trans guys who don't want bottom surgery get more hate or less hate than trans women who don't want bottom surgery?
I think it all comes down to the whole male dominating thing in general. Like, they just come down to, oh, well, you're just a dude with, or a chick with a dick. I think it's harder for trans women. There's that idolized way of women have to have a vagina and they have to have boobs. Where a trans man, okay, you were a female at one point in time, like, I get it, because it's not like a real functioning dick or da 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 da.
So when you have a sexual partner, what do you tell them to reference your genitalia?
I still say clit.
You do?
I still say clit. You know, say we're like talking or something and we go home and she's like, I wanna get fucked by your dick. I'm gonna assume you want me to use like a strap-on. Now, if you're saying like, I wanna take you home and I wanna fuck you, I'm gonna assume just my body. Skin on skin, you know, what we got, that's how we're having sex. I still look at it as a clit, little clit dick. It's a clit dick. I would say dick would be referring to more of a strap-on toy for me, and clit doesn't, you know, make me uncomfortable, anything like that, or make me feel any less masculine like some people would think. If you are comfortable as yourself, if you perceive yourself as a man, if everything is good and you are comfortable with what you have, work the shit out of it. Do not hate it. Do not be ashamed. Don't let somebody tell you that you need bottom surgery. My advice is don't be ashamed. I think the biggest thing too is people like to tell you what they need to see from you. You don't need bottom surgery to be a man.